Welcome to Fire Desire, where you are empowered to fulfill your God-given destiny. Now, your host, Pastor Rodney Crewse.
Praise God, this is Pastor Rodney Crewse. Welcome you to Fire Desire, and this is our first program of 2016. If you were with us this past year, you know, the Lord gave us a word about 2015 to be a season of miracles. And some of you did see miracles, and others say, well, I'm still kind of dragging behind. But I want to encourage you that 2016 is a year of breakthroughs. But you know, breakthroughs doesn't come the way we'd often like. Sometimes they come with a little bit of resistance. And so I'm going to talk about that for the next couple of programs, and I want to encourage you to even record them if you can have that ability, or, and for sure, call a friend right now. Father, in Jesus' name, we thank you for your power. We thank you for your Holy Spirit. We thank you, Lord, for being with us this year of 2016. I ask you to bless all of that's watching this program, Lord, and watches Channel 38. I pray, Father, for their deliverance, their breakthroughs in 2016. Amen. You know, the message today in the next couple of weeks is called The Power of Resistance. Now, in the natural, we don't really like resistance. We want things to be smooth and no problems at all. But resistance is actually a healthy thing. So we're going to talk about it. Now, in the natural, there's something called resistance training. And that training then requires resistance, obviously, to build muscles. So if you've ever pumped weights, for example, and, you know, say you just grab a set of weights you haven't worked out in a long time, and you just start pumping some weights. I should have brought some with me today to show you. Well, what happens is the first time you do it, the first few times right off the bat, your muscles will actually swell up. And, you know, but this is just extra blood flow going into your muscle area. And so you feel like you could conquer the world. You know, man, your muscles get bigger. But you notice they don't stay like that. You know, if you just grab them every once in a while, you pump a few weights. And a matter of fact, bodybuilders who actually go to these shows and stuff, right before they go out, they do all this pumping. They pump themselves up and they swell their muscles up. Well, it's kind of like, you know, you get this short-term increase, and that's in the natural. But long-term resistance training actually increases the size of the muscle. You know, increases the size of the muscle by increasing what we call the cross-sectional area of the muscle fibers. Now, this actually, if you look in the spiritual, you know, it's like kind of going to a conference. So you go to a conference, you get all pumped up, and it lasts a few days. And we need those. I believe in them. But what happens if you don't carry on? And you don't carry on? Well, pretty soon, that spiritual muscle, you might say, it goes back down. And you didn't really gain any strength at all because you didn't maintain that. So resistance is kind of like, it's kind of like the devil. You know, we don't really like Satan. And we shouldn't. But, you know, a lot of people don't realize that he's here for resistance. And believe it or not, God wasn't confused, or he didn't make this big mistake. And for Satan is here as a resistance to actually strengthen you, not destroy you. We know Satan came to kill, steal, and destroy. That's his purpose. Now, as we're going in deeper into it, I want you to realize that our natural tendency is to lessen pain, lessen resistance. But we're going to look at scriptures today and next week that may surprise us a bit about what we call resistance. So I'm going to also read some more about the natural. You know, resistance increases bone strength. It says activities that stimulate bone growth need to include progressive overload, variation of load, and specificity of loading. In other words, specific loading. So progressive overload, variation of load, and specificity of loading. In other words, refers to exercise that directly place a load on certain regions of the skeleton. the specific areas of the skeleton. You realize that gravity is resistance. And if you didn't have any gravity, actually your bone mass would become very, you know, I mean, your bones would actually shrink. You ever notice someone who maybe has had a disease or something, they've not been able to work their muscles or use their legs? What happens to them? They shrink. And a lot of people will say, well, looky there. Look what that disease has done. Well, that's true in some senses, but what's really happened is the lack of use, lack of resistance has caused a shrinkage. And, you know, you think about what we call resistance training. Again, we're back to resistance training. It says resistance training can increase fat-free mass and decrease the percentage of body fat. One of the outstanding benefits of resistance exercise, it produces weight loss, encouraging loss of body fat. Now, I have a little side note. When it comes to spiritual matters, a lot of people are fat on the word. A lot of people are fat on the word. But they don't like or accept resistance. They rebuke it. See, resistance is a healthy thing. Now, let's talk about the size of hearts. Into those who are in resistance training, it says, studies of resistance trained athletes have shown that there's an increase in left ventricular wall thickness. Absolute left ventricular wall mass. So in other words, strength exercise or resistance training increases your heart strength. Now, obviously, if we think of in the spiritual now, resistance increases your heart size. So it's capacity for love. You know, how many times do we say, well, you know, I didn't really appreciate that, them going through it until I went through it. And what happened is our heart got increased, the size of love it can handle. This comes from resistance. And again, I know this is not popular because we don't like resistance. We want things smooth, microwave, you know. But the fact is, in our society today, even applies to parents, you know, a lot of children today, not all, but a lot of children today, or maybe they're not corrected the way they used to be and so forth. And we'll talk about that. A lot of parents think, well, my job is to make my child's life easy. Well, this isn't real spiritual, but I think of the show McClintock with John Wayne. There come a time when he talked to his daughter and he said to her, he says, listen, you know, a lot of people think you're going to inherit all this land and cattle and all the things he owned. He owned mines and all this stuff. And he says, well, you're not. He says, I'm going to leave it for a national park, and I have reserved you a 500-cow spread over in such and such area. And he said, it's because I love you. See, he wanted to be easy for her, but he didn't want it to be too easy for her and her future husband. They needed some resistance. They needed some challenges to build them up, to strengthen them as a couple. Now, we're going to look at a few examples in the Bible. We all mostly have heard the story of David and Goliath, right? Well, David needed a Goliath to become king. Do you realize that? David needed a Goliath to become king. What if he had never... You know, he said, well, the prophet already anointed him king. That's why. Well, listen, the fact is, though, it was the conquering of the Goliath. It was the conquering of the giant in his life that really pushed him forward. He needed a Goliath in his life. He needed resistance. I know we've also heard the story of Joseph, right? The coat of many colors and his jealous brothers threw him in a pit. Well, I want you to look at it differently. Joseph needed the pit to end up in the palace. He needed the pit. He needed that resistance. Moses, and we look at Moses in the wilderness. Well, Moses needed 40 years in the wilderness to be used of God. You say, well, I don't have 40 years. Well, I got news for us. You know, God has things. Now listen, first of all, I want to tell you, the Lord does not tempt you with sin. That's very clear in the Bible. Satan comes to kill, steal, and destroy, and Jesus comes that we might have life and have it more abundantly. But God does allow testings. He does put situations and allow situations that test us, tries us, tries our faith. He does allow that resistance that causes growth. Now we think of Jonah and the whale. Jonah needed a whale in his life to help him see the love and mercy of God. He needed to see the love and mercy of God, the God that was willing to forgive even Nineveh, a wicked city. But Jonah needed some resistance. He needed some testing. He needed some tribulation. And I know, again, often, especially Spirit-filled folks, we always want to resist these challenges. But we're going to see what Paul says about them later on as we read some scriptures. You know, Zechariah, you remember Zechariah, well, the father of John the Baptist. Well, Zechariah needed to lose his voice to understand the power of our words. Zechariah needed to lose his voice for a season to understand the power of our words. So Zechariah needed some resistance, and out of it his heart grew larger for God. His faith toward God grew more, not less. Abraham and Ishmael. Well, we wish to goodness, and I'm sure the country of Israel wishes that Abraham hadn't done this, you know, went into Hagar and Ishmael was conceived. But Abraham needed an Ishmael to learn not to settle for second best. He needed to learn not to settle for second best. Now listen, the Bible says that God never gives us more than we can handle, right? He doesn't allow us to be tested beyond what we can handle. Now sometimes we got to remind ourselves of this, because sometimes the testing is so heavy that we say, Lord, you know, this is too much. Well, again, let's talk about the balance. The Lord does not tempt you with sin. Right? There's no sin in heaven, so he doesn't have any sin to tempt you with. There's no sin in the kingdom of God. But he does allow these tests and trials to try your faith, to build your patience and strengthen you. As we said, even in the natural, you've got to have resistance. And there was a show, sort of a kid's movie, but any parent could get something from it too. There was a movie called Wall-E. And in that movie, the earth had been destroyed, pretty much, by the way the people abused it and so forth. And now these people are living up in space. And the people got so lazy, they didn't even walk no more. They didn't do anything. Well, they'd gotten fat. You know, they'd gotten really big. And they couldn't even use their legs. There was no resistance. And this is a problem, I think, even in the body of Christ. You know, we're going to take a look at why we need to, there's power in resistance. Well, we've all heard of Daniel in the lion's den, haven't we? Well, Daniel needed a lion's den to change a nation. Daniel needed a lion's den to change a nation. Now, so, you know, if you just say always rebuking everything that ever seems to be negative to your world. Again, we're not talking about tax from Satan. We're not talking about anything like that. But when things happen, if you learn to rest in the fact that the Lord never gives you more than you can handle, and if there's any temptation involved from the devil, the Lord will then also provide you a way of escape, according to the scriptures. So, you know, we can rest in this. Now, what about the Apostle Paul? I have the Apostle Paul and the tall horse. You know that the Apostle Paul needed a tall horse to fall off of, you know? And so what happened is Paul needed to be knocked off a high horse to see the truth. He had a little resistance happening here, and he found out the ground was pretty hard. You know, the ground was pretty hard. And it woke him up to something. Now, again, you say, well, the Lord wouldn't knock nobody off their horse like that. Well, he did. The glory of God knocked him off his tall, high horse, thinking he was so great and knew all things about the law and all the things like that. Well, Paul needed a tall horse to fall off of. And so what about children and correction? Children and correction. Again, in our society today, a lot of people embrace this thing of just, you know, well, let's keep little Johnny or little Sally happy. And so there's been no they've taken away the resistance. And so with that resistance taken away, the children are not maturing. You can't mature without resistance. And see, when we get a hold of this, you know, we're going to read some scriptures here in a little bit from Paul that just blow you away, what he says about it. Okay? So a child needs correction to find the right path. A child needs correction to find the right path. Sometimes mothers, because they're nurturers, they want to ease resistance of the child. Okay? And don't get me wrong, you know, that we need to have that, but we need to also realize that, well, I'll tell you a true story. When we lived in Wichita, Kansas many years ago, you know, there was this mother who, every time little Johnny, he's growing up. I mean, he's getting big enough now, he should be talking and so forth. Well, every time in the past, he'd just, he'd just point at something. And his mother would, is that it, little Johnny? You know. And so he was 5 years old, went to the doctor, and he couldn't even talk. There was no resistance in the vocal cords. There was no, all he had to do was just grunt, you know. And the doctor actually rebuked the mother. He said, you need to make him say what he wants. He's heard these words. Make him try to say what he wants and needs at 5 years old. Okay? Well, the same things happen in the body of Christ. You know, people, they wonder, I just don't know why nothing good happens to me. Well, you're still on the milk. Okay? So, you know, as there's been no resistance, you know, it takes a little resistance to chew meat. You know, anybody can pretty well, unless your throat's all in bad shape, you can drink some liquids. So, you know, Paul had a whole people that said, I wish I could give you meat, but you're still on the milk. And so meat causes resistance and builds muscles. Starting to eat foods builds jaw muscles. Well, so a child, they need correction. They don't always need the easy path. And sometimes they need to learn what it means to lose. Because you know what? In this world, I don't care if you're the greatest athlete that was ever born, you're going to lose sometime. All right? And so in our society, though, we're taking away this resistance. Don't want to hurt little Sally's feelings. And so everybody's a winner. But that mentality is not scriptural. It really isn't, as much as you think it is. There's times we need knocked off our high horse. There's times we need to face reality that sometimes it's not going to go the way we planned. But this doesn't mean that's our defeat, okay? But if you've been trained ever since you was little that anything negative, you know, that's negative, I rebuke the devil, you know. Well, sometimes you're going to be rebuking God. Because God's trying to build you your spiritual muscles. God's trying to grow you up and get you chewing some meat. But, you know, that's why it applies both the natural and spiritual. Now, we can take it further. What about Jesus in the wilderness? 40 days. The Bible says, after John the Baptist baptized him, you know, it says the Spirit led him into the wilderness to be tested. The King James says tempted, but the actual word is tested. Because the Spirit of God is not going to lead you into temptation, but He will lead you into testing. So, Jesus needed 40 days in the wilderness. Yeah, Jesus. The Spirit said He needed it. The Spirit led Him into the wilderness to be tested of the devil. And can you imagine, tested 40 days, no food or water. He was getting ready to embark on a ministry to change the world forever. And the Bible says in the book of Luke that He returned in the power of the Spirit. He returned in the power of the Spirit. So testing, trials, tribulations are not to destroy you. They're to return you in the power. They're to take you to the power of God, not for your defeat. But if you never allow testing, you never allow any little tribulation, you say, well, you know, God would want me to have it the easiest way. Well, most people, if they're honest, what would they say to you? Well, I really learned it the hard way, which means I never forgot it. And it stuck with me, and I gained something from it. And so Jesus also needed a cross, didn't he? He needed a cross to save the world. He needed resistance. And this is something that what if he had never, what if he had not, what if he had rebuked the cross? What if he said, Lord, Father, there's no way. I mean, I don't need to go to the cross. That's too painful. Well, we know what he said in the garden, right? He was praying in the garden. And he said, Father, not my will, your will be done. He didn't rebuke the test. He embraced the test by saying, Lord, I'll do what you want me to do. And so then he had perfect peace. He saw the end from the beginning. Okay, Lord, this is what you have me to do. I'm doing it. And so he embraced the resistance. And through it, he saved the world. So we think about all the people in the Bible who either embraced resistance or they resisted resistance. Now, I'm going to read a couple of scriptures, and then next week we'll cover a lot more scriptures on this, but I wanted to lay the groundwork. In 1 Peter 4:12, it says, Beloved, think it not strange concerning the fiery trial which is to try you as though some strange thing happened unto you. You know, I was thinking of some people, you know, just over the years, and you hear someone just complaining and complaining about somebody they work with. Oh, just complaining about somebody they work with. Maybe we've all done it. But the thing is, do you think the Lord was surprised who you work with? You think the Lord was surprised by where you work, when you work, what year you're there? Did you ever think maybe you're being tested and tried until you pass the test? So, you know, the Bible says what? To do good them that despitefully use you. Pray for those. Well, we don't like that scripture, Rodney. Well, until we embrace and understand the Lord, that all things really do work together for the good, that them are called according to His purpose and love Him. They really do, okay? And when you really believe the Bible, and you really know, then there's nothing. As long as you're walking with God daily, as long as you're starting your day right, and you're saying, Lord, not my will, your will be done today. And you'll never be caught off guard. And if something comes along, something that seems negative or hurtful or whatever, you'll discern right away, is this the devil that needs rebuked or is this resistance I need to embrace? And there's a big difference. Something we got to realize. He says, don't think it's strange. Why do you think it's strange that a fiery trial comes your way as though something weird or something's happening to you that's happened to nobody else? Well, so he's encouraging us to say, look, okay, Lord, you know all about this. You knew I was going to go through this. Therefore, your grace is sufficient for me. That means your strength is made perfect in my weakness. In James 1:3-4, it says, knowing this, that the trying of your faith worketh patience. But let patience have her perfect work, that ye may be perfect, entire, wanting nothing. Now that is quite a statement. If you let patience have its perfect work, if you, instead of rebuking resistance, you embrace it by faith, saying, okay, Lord, another test to pass. And after every test comes power. It says you'll get to the point, you'll be perfect, and you won't want anything. In other words, when he grows us up into likeness of himself, that we don't have any needs then because we're walking like he walked. You say, well, that ain't possible. Well, it is. And we'll see scriptures next week that talk about that. In fact, the whole Ephesians 4 talk about the purpose of church leadership to grow us up into the image of God and the fullness of Christ. So today, as we are winding down quickly, is let's just look back quickly. So there's natural resistance. You know, like I said, I was almost going to bring some weights here where you could see. Not to brag, but if you pump weight, pretty soon my muscle's going to start swelling up. And that's kind of like a meeting that we just run to here. I'm not against them. I have them myself. But if that's all we have, and then we don't come home to a home church where we get fed weekly, then we just had a little short swelling of the spiritual muscles and felt good for a little bit. And then we go back to the devil kicking our teeth in. And that's not the way God wants it. So be sure to tune in next week as we carry on this message that I believe will set the stage for 2016 for you. Because you're going to have resistance, but it's how you handle it this year that's going to determine whether you break through. All right. So Father, in Jesus' name, I lift up all those that's watching, and I thank you, Father, that they're going to discern what is from the devil, and they're going to discern what is something that you're allowing so that they mature. Give them that discernment this year, Lord, that they don't find themselves rebuking you. And I believe for great breakthroughs this year and all those that watch this program and other programs on Channel 38, this is a year of breakthrough like we've never saw before in the kingdom of God. And I pray for all of those that they would experience it in their lives in Jesus' name. All right. So be sure to tune in next week to continuation message of there's power in resistance. God bless, and we'll see you next week.
Thank you for joining us for Fire Desire. You may contact us at firedesiretv.org or write to Fire Desire TV, Post Office Box 797, Kabul, Missouri 65689.